Test 1, 2.
Sega!
Sega! Oh yeah, now we're talking. Good morning, boys and girls. Evening, if it's evening where you are now, or afternoon, or night. I don't know. This is a cool game. This was a really good Mega Drive game. Loads of accolades for this, and quite rightly too. Comix on Sega Mega Drive. You can see straight away that the quality is right up there. I have got good memories of this game. This reminds me of my mate Steve, my best mate Steve. He's pretty much the person who's been the most constant in my life. And he's still about now, and we're just as close as we ever were. We don't see each other as much as we should, as is always the case with your mates, especially when you live. I'm only an hour away from him. In American terms, that's nothing, but in UK terms, that's quite a lot. Awesome intro. You get the idea from the story. He's a comic artist, but me and Steve used to keep trying to draw comics from your kids. I did a few videos back that you might remember. My last talkie, I think it is. Might not be the last one by now. I've probably done another talkie since that I've done after this, but put out before this. Okay, that's the demo, or is it? It appears to be the game. I'm straight to the game. Oh yeah, of course I did press that. Sketch Turner off on a mission. Yeah, me and Steve used to play this game. We used to draw comics at his house after school and just had a boss time of it. As young teenagers, look at the animation, it's beautiful. So this reminds me of Steve. I'm just going to go in at him with my fist. I'm sure there's some kicking I can do. Yeah, there we go. He's getting a bit handy, isn't he, actually? Travis. That was a good Travis voice. Actually, that was like Sturgill. Sturgill. What's he say? I can't believe he says that. My memory's been terrible last week. No, I can't. We'll have to find out when we get to it. He says something. See ya. That's it. Pack it in. That's what he says. Pack it in. It's such a cool phrase. It sounds quite a scouse phrase to me. Pack it in. Pack it in. What's something with it, what's wearing? Yeah, this was a great game. I mean, I'm not doing the fight mechanics just to say I'm just going in, but they are really good. That's where we pick different weapons. Now they're using up something else later on. Let's go right. I can't really remember which way we're supposed to go. I've just thrown my knife at the bin. That was silly. I don't know how or why I did that. Sound effects were always a little bit squidgy, Mega Drive-y, you know. But it didn't matter. I love all the little bits of, look at the page bits with shadows under them. It's so cool. Ah, there, look at it. It's like the blood effect of the game, but it's such a nice touch. Well done, Turner. Let's go down, yeah. This was the first game I hooked. Well, no, it wasn't the first game I worked. No, that isn't as cool as it sounds. You'll find out why in a sec. I did that vertical lines thing in this version too. We did it in the Game Boy version. Basically, yeah. That was introducing you to other game mechanics. If I can, there we go. Now do I do that? I'll do that. Just push the water. That's awesome. It's beautiful as well. I think we just gotta smash these. Yeah. After I, before I went to university, I went in a few other games, but this was the first one that I actually had any hand in as an industry professional after my education. This was at Virtucraft Studios, and we did the Game Boy Advance version, which again was met with some acclaim. Back it in. Back it in. And there we go. Back it in. And I was a very junior artist at Virtucraft, and I got to do a bit of just a few bits and pieces on this. I don't think I was credited because I didn't have the nerve to go, actually, I work on it. They came round and said, we work on this game, we work on that game. And I didn't feel like, totally me, I didn't feel like the nerve or the right, if you like, to say. I did a bit on that, so I don't think I got credited on this. And various other ones, Rocky being one and two, as I mentioned on Dave Lomboy's post. I was proud of this game in Rocky, but again, I didn't do enough. Oh, that's what you're supposed to do, put that down there. Mike, you're an idiot. There's a reason that was there. You walk against the wall and it pushes it, your feet push it out, and it's such a nice sort of physicky thing. Just keep away from them. such a nice touch. Yeah, so I did a bit of, I can't remember what I mean, but it was mostly tidying up. And it was mostly playtesting, to be honest, because it was the first few weeks of it. It's a shame, I'd love to have been there earlier and done more on this. But my lead artist, Paul Scott, did most of the work on this. Paul's like, I haven't seen like a long time. Well, like a year or two. Oh no! Oh, I did the cardinal error of falling down a hole. That's the worst thing about Comic Zone. You've just seen it right there. You fall down a hole, you die. You die, that's it. No lives. No anything. You die. So you can get to like the last bit of the game and slip down a hole. And that's it. Game over, man. Game over. I'm not going to play it again because you've seen as much as I can do in another 5 minutes. It's awesome. If you haven't played it, that's quite good. I died quite early. Play it and get further than I did. It's brilliant. Brilliant game. It is brilliant. I need to probably buy that for your Mega Drive collection. That is on my list of games to buy for my Mega Drive original. But it's not cheap. Well, it's not that expensive, but it's too expensive for me because I'm poor. But I will get around to getting that at some point. Awesome game. Go and play it if you haven't already. Comic Zone, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.